Hey everybody, this is Sanjeev from Tackle. In today's video, we are going to check how to add Google Maps to your WordPress site. I am going to use a plugin called Google Maps Widget. The plugin is available free of cost in the WordPress repository. Just go to your regular plugin panel and search for Google Maps Widget. Google Maps Widget is offered by Web Factory Limited, so just click on Install now. And once it's installed, just activate. So once it is installed, you can go to the settings menu and select the settings of Google Maps widget. Once you come here, there are options of settings where you can actually add a lot of general settings, especially your Google Maps API key, so that your Google Maps can display correctly. You have an option of import and export, but that's only available in the pro version, and a pro license. The plugin offers a pro license or at a very nominal cost, so if you are looking for a more customization option, you can definitely look for a pro license key. For my demonstration, I have a pro license key with me, so I'm just going to click on enter the key and enter my key here. Once it is activated, it's going to ask for update Google Maps widget plugin, because it's going to replace the plugin with a pro license. So just click on that and it will update your plugin installation with the latest files for the pro version. Once everything is done, just returns to plugin page, just click on activate and activate the Google Maps widget pro. The next thing which you need to do is go to your Google Maps pro widget settings and add a Google Maps API key. This API key will allow your maps to be displayed correctly. So once you add the Google Maps API, just click on test API key and you will get a results back. Once that is done, you have certain settings available to you. You can actually select what shortcode you want to use. Do you want to use the Google Analytics? You want to include jQuery, include Google Maps API JS, Colorbox JS, and all that other stuff. You can do general settings from here. Once the plugin is active, what exactly it does is it actually adds a hidden sidebar in your widget section. So if you go now on your widget section, you will see Google Maps Widget Pro hidden sidebar. This sidebar is not going to be visible on your site, but this allows you to create your maps and keep saving them here. So if you pick your Google Maps widget, add it to this sidebar, you can customize it here and save it, so that later on whenever you want to use, you can use it in your post and pages. You can give it any title. I will leave as it is right now, but you can change your title. Here you can define your address, and once you want to make sure that address is correct, click on this. It's going to pick up and show you the address. You can actually correct your coordinates or closest matching address and finalize that exactly what you want to use here. This is a map default size. By default it's 250 by 250, but you can actually change it according to your need. Type of map you want, a satellite, hybrid, terrain. There are certain color themes which is available, so you can choose themes which are matching to your sites. Zoom level, pin type. This is another good feature. So you can actually select what pin type you want to use. You can select predefined by Google, or you can use a pins library. And pins library means you can actually see a pin image here. And if you click on open pins library, you will see there are so many types of pins available. You can select any of that and that pin will be used in this map. There are certain options which you can use in terms of how you want to display the map. I usually prefer interactive maps in lightbox, but you can select certain different types of maps also. You can put some of the text which you can add above and below also. Pins is another good option. Most of the time you would need one pin, but if you have multiple offline locations which you want to display in a single map, you can enable multiple pin and you can add new addresses there. So once you do everything, you have to click on save, and once you save the map, it will actually give you a shortcode. This shortcode is something which you can copy and use it in any of your post or page to display this map. Okay, so we have done everything. Now if we go to one of our pages, so suppose we go to page and we'll just edit any of the page. So if I go here and I add that map here and say update, now if I go and see the page, I will see a map added here. And if you click on that map, it's going to open up in a lightbox which actually allows you to zoom in, zoom out. You can actually select things here and interact like normal. come out and it's back to the image. So that's how easy it is to add a map with this plugin. And you can actually define multiple maps and keep adding them. The benefit of this is if later on you want to change the address, you don't have to change each and every post. Just go to your widget section and update the address in that map. It will be reflected in each and every page. So if you have multiple offline location and you keep adding maps to a different pages, I would suggest you to take a look at Google Maps widget plugin. It's available free in WordPress repository. There are some customization option which is available along with Pro, but without that also you can actually use it and display your maps correctly on your WordPress posts and pages. Hope this video helps you in displaying your maps correctly in your WordPress posts and pages. If you like the video, just hit the like button below or subscribe to Tackle for more tips around WordPress.